the connection was in the marrow of our bones, because our parents never left Ireland behind.
'37, '38, I was, you know, 6, 7, 8 years old. And our playground actually was the streets.
Then you would just sit on this stoop, which was so entertaining, and watch this wonderful life go by of the Brooklyn neighborhood.
Upon graduation, I was watching my dad exhaling, letting it all out. It was almost like him going to bed and saying, "Dear Lord, it's all over. I did it all." And went to sleep. Never woke up.
I've got dreams.
She was a beautiful baby. She was like a little China doll.
I wheeled her all the avenue. We lived on 97th Street. I used to wheel her to the Change Club on 62nd Street. Having a couple of beers, wheel her back.
Well, it's 1 for the money, 2 for the show, 3 to get ready, now go get going, but don't you step on my blue shoes.
The 50s, we would go to dances, come home at 2 in the morning, and it was nothing to worry about. It did change. It was getting seedy looking, and it was getting, there was a little more crime.
Now I know.
This house and this town is very sacred to them, and they have a lot of special memories about this place.
Among the first to arrive was Rescue Company 2 from Brooklyn, and my nephew Billy Lake, 20-year veteran, senior member of Rescue 2, was among the firefighters of Rescue 2 that got killed that day. And I would venture to say 30 personal friends.
Grandkids, you just sit there and watch it all unfold and love every bit of it. It just fills your heart.
They're there for them all the time, anytime we want them, and they're such a big part of my kids' lives, and I feel so lucky that my kids will grow up with them, and they're going to be here for a long, long time, and it's really nice to see them so involved and so wanting to be with them. Now they have the freedom to do that.
We take for granted our own lives and how blessed we are and how well we've been taken care of. And I think that, you know, the older I get and the more I see other people's lives, the more I realize, like, I'm very, very grateful. Very grateful for the family that I have and the parents that I've had.
I just feel I've been very, very lucky. Feel like I've been very lucky. You know, we've had deaths in our family, we've lost our parents. That's the way life is. But I feel we have much more than I ever dreamed possible.
I would never think that. I would look around and seeing this family and what they've accomplished, I would never think that it would be happening. I'm so grateful for all we have. There's not a day that I don't say thanks to our Lord. Not a day. I just say thanks.